A Coati kitten, just 6 weeks old. The time has come for it to leave the safety of the canopy. But danger lurks down there. Hungry bush dogs and a spider with venom that will kill. Where the mighty Iguazu Falls borders Brazil's Mata Atlântica, subtropical forests flourish. Beneath the canopy, a band of ring-tailed coatis have their noses in the leaf litter, searching for food. The coati is about the size of a house cat and distantly related to the raccoon. Its snout is very flexible and can bend up to 60% in any direction to sniff out danger and to forage for whatever the forest might have to offer. Invertebrates, fruit that's in season, and tiny insects hiding in bromeliads high in the canopy. Eggs, small frogs, lizards, but perhaps not this lizard. The golden tegu has bone-crushing teeth and can grow as big as an adult coati. Coatis are extremely social. They hang out in bands of up to 30 females and kittens. A female only leaves the group to give birth high up in the trees. After about 6 weeks, she returns to the band and her babies follow. At least most of them do. This little one started to climb over 2 weeks ago. The canopy is the only home it knows. It's not as if going down means never returning. From now on, the youngster will have the best of both worlds and the best possible care. Being social requires cooperation beyond the family. Females will even suckle the offspring of other mothers. But like most males, this youngster will leave the safety of the band at 2 years old when he is sexually mature. He'll live alone in the forest. Going solo has its advantages. No family to protect, dinner for one. With strong claws and large, sharp canine teeth, the adult male coati is built to survive alone. And he's double the size of the female. This may be one of the reasons why the females are such social animals. Together, they can compete against a male for food and win. Alone, they wouldn't stand a chance. There's power in numbers, as well as responsibility. Females will have between 2 and 7 kittens in each litter. When a band gets too big, it splits into smaller foraging groups. That means fewer mouths to feed and fewer babies to keep an eye on. There are lots of inexperienced youngsters here who need constant surveillance. And so does the forest. Coatis have many predators. One is very rare and elusive. The bush dog is the smallest member of the canine family, roughly the size of a terrier. It has some things in common with the coati. It's active during the day, and it's a very social animal, living in family groups of between 2 and 12 individuals. But unlike the coati's female-led band, the bush dog group is led by a dominant couple. They're the only male and female allowed to breed. These dogs like water, especially rivers. They use them as highways to patrol their territory. The coati band also uses the river to visit their foraging territories. They may be walking into a trap. The alpha bush dog pair enters the thick forest to mark their territory. Their urine has a distinct odor, well known to the coati's nose. They can sniff out and hear their predators before they see them. Tail held high like a flag, the female shows the escape route. It's time to make a swift exit. This is when babies risk being separated from the band. But in this case, not a single one was lost to the dogs. The youngsters are back in their comfort zone. Fear is replaced by fun. And now that the threat has passed, one of the mothers leads the troop back down to the forest floor. It's a nose-first descent, thanks to double-jointed ankles that can rotate through 180 degrees. Perhaps now they can forage in peace. A fallen log holds protein-rich grubs, and the leaf litter contains plenty of insects and arachnids. Coatis love eating spiders. Before eating a tarantula, they'll rub it on the ground to remove its stinging hairs. But this is no tarantula. It's a Brazilian wandering spider, and it's thought to be the most toxic arachnid in the world. Disturbing this nocturnal spider from its retreat in the leaf litter can be fatal. The spider displays an aggressive upright posture, a defense and a warning. Its venom can paralyze. Today, the forest floor is a death trap, better observed from above. Many eyes to detect predators with is one of the benefits of a sociable lifestyle. And for the adult females, there's a hidden advantage. It's recently been discovered that working together to ward off predators, find food, and raise each other's kittens has increased their brain power. The part of the brain normally associated with social activity in primates is bigger in coati females that band together than in solitary males. But don't worry, the males are doing just fine. They visit the females once a year, a social call to make sure the next generation of ring-tailed coatis can join the band. Want to see more of Brazil's amazing wildlife? Check out our playlist and please do consider to subscribe for more great videos.